Hi. I can see Venus, and in a little while I'll show her to you. I wanted to talk about the difference between Memorial Day, which is the weekend we're at right now, and Veterans Day, which is in November. Now, many of you, at least the ones of you I know, you already know the difference. I mean, aside from the fact that one is the beginning of summer and the other is the 11th of November, 30th of May, and the 11th of November. Except we've changed them all to Mondays now, haven't we? Well, we usually think of them both as celebrating the people who've done service for our nation, the United States of America. Although, the 11th of November is also celebrated in Europe because it was the end of World War I. To your health and to the health of all our beloved friends, especially those who have served our nation and our people. And while I'm on the subject, to your nation and your people, whatever country you may be in. Well, yeah. Memorial Day, and my understanding is it began the end of the Civil War in the United States. The war ended in April, and on the 15th, or maybe it was the 16th, I forget the exact date, Abraham Lincoln was assassinated at the theater, and Memorial Day was set up the end of May, May 30th, to memorialize all the people, the men and the women who had served this nation during the Great War between the states, the Great Rebellion, the Civil War. There's a Civil War going on right now with a dog barking over there. Anyhow, Memorial Day, which is what we're celebrating this weekend, is to remember, to memorialize the memory, memorial, all those who died in service to the nation. The Civil War was a great, terrible judgment and punishment upon the United States. Some people said it was the blood for the crime of slavery. Other people said, no, it was just parts of the country fighting each other. But in fact, it was an imperial war to create, recreate the American nation and to drive home with the force of death that states could not leave the Union. I suppose a political or a constitutional argument could be made that since Congress has the power to admit states to the Union, Congress might also have the power to allow states to leave. Ah, the dog wants in. I hope someone will let her in. If not, I'll have to get up and let her in. The states, commonly known as the southern states, the slave states, seceded, declared in their own little... There we go. Thank you. Declared in their own legislatures, because each state has its own legislature and governor. That's the thing about the United States. It was set up to allow each state to handle some of the affairs and have the federal government handle other affairs. It's sort of like a balance. Anyway, the war was fought because the states not only seceded, but then they attacked federal property. The most famous being the federal fort in Charleston, South Carolina. And Lincoln decided, and his fellow Republicans agreed with him, that this was an act of war, and the northern states would go to war against the southern states and bring them back into the Union, that the Union could not be dissolved. And after 4 years of brutal and bloody and deadly warfare, the last southern armies surrendered. Much of the South had been occupied by northern troops. New Orleans, Kentucky and Tennessee, Mississippi, northern Virginia, and then all of Virginia. And then there was General Sherman and his army that marched from Tennessee all the way over the mountains and down into Georgia to Atlanta and all the way to the Atlantic Ocean. And that was the occupation of Georgia. And then there was a great battle fought around Richmond, and the city fell. There were so many battles in that war and so many people killed, I get them all mixed up in my brain. But we are remembering them here in the United States on Memorial Day. All of the men and women and the children of the northern states and of the southern states, of the Union, and the rebels who died and who killed in that terrible war. Some people say it was the first modern war, because they used rifles that could be quickly reloaded, just click, click, and you could put a new shot in the chamber. That was it. Oh, there's Venus. Right there. On their motorcycles. Yeah. And that was a pretty awful war. We've had wars over and over through the centuries. In Europe, century after century, from the Middle Ages, the French and the English, and the French and the Italians, and the Spanish and the Italians, and this. It just goes on and on. And then there was the war of the Protestant Reformation went on through Germany, and which brings us down through the 1700s when the French were fighting, in the late 1700s when Napoleon started fighting against other countries with his dream of bringing all of Europe together into one great liberal empire. In 1812, I guess it was, when he lost his great army in Russia. And then through the 1800s, for a while, they kept what they call the balance of power. Germany, France, Spain, England, and the small nations, Belgium, Netherlands. Italy became unified out of many different city-states and the Kingdom of Naples. The Austrian Empire conquered Hungary and Bulgaria, and Germany became unified, uniting the different kingdoms, and especially Bavaria and Prussia. Poland went up and down through the centuries and ended up being divided a couple of times. And then there was the war between the French and the Germans, the Franco-Prussian War in the late 1800s. And then there was the Great War. Broke out in 1914 and didn't end until the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918. And that, my friends, Armistice Day, November 11th, is what we in the United States celebrate as Veterans Day. Some people say that World War I was just the first part of World War II, that World War II was the second part of World War I. Officially, World War II began in 1938 when the Russians took Eastern Poland and Nazis Germany took Western Poland. And the Brits and the French declared war on Germany. Don't ask me why they didn't declare war on the Soviet Union, but they didn't. And they ended up becoming allies with the Soviet Union against Germany when, a couple years later, Germany attacked Russia, the Soviet Union, which shocked Stalin. Stalin thought he had a deal with Hitler. Of course, a lot of people thought they had deals with Hitler. It goes to show you, you can't make a deal with Adolf Hitler. Whatever that means. But I was thinking today about Memorial Day and the difference between the holidays here in the United States. And we celebrate people who served the nation. especially in the war, in the military. And so I thought I'd come out here and, looking at the Star of Peace, Venus, I would talk a little bit about what Memorial Day and Veterans Day means to me. Yeah, it's time to let the dog outside. There she is. That's the big white dog. Oh, you don't want to watch her go poop, so I'll move the camera. Avert your eyes. Back to Venus. See how it's getting low right over the house? Coming down. Coming down. Venus is coming down. And that's about all I have to say about Venus and Memorial Day and Veterans Day. And I hope all of you will have a good summer, a safe summer. A friend of mine in Australia wrote to me and said that they've gone on to another lockdown. And I was sorry to hear that. Got her email the other day. Yeah. So I'm thinking of her too, far away in Oz. But I'll just say, good night for now, and wish you all the best, and here's to your health. Goodbye.